Hi, this is Marcus. The first tutorial of PortraitPro 18 Studio Max, I gave you a general overview of how the application works, and we also saved the preset. This is a copy of that image that I actually did in the prior tutorial. This is a local model that I work with by the name of Mela. I created a preset based upon her face. And so what batch processing will allow you to do is apply that preset to a series of photos. So just say, for instance, I have a bunch of photos or a number of photos that I need to deliver to this model or to a bride or to whatever the job is. And I need to process and I want the look to be consistent. I've taken the time to actually create the preset. Now that I've created the preset, I need to apply this to multiple files. This is where this product exceeds beyond Photoshop, because Photoshop is a destructive editing application that you can use in a non-destructive way. And it requires you to create layers and layer masks and add filters to manually add these things, because it doesn't know how to do it. Right, because you have to instruct it on what you want to do with the application. Whereas these adjustments are made based upon the selection of the model's face or the subject's face and the outline of the eyes and nose and mouth. And based upon that, it remembers based on the preset of how to process and apply these edits that you've done. So let me just go ahead and just show you how it works. We're going to open a batch file. So here are four photos that we're going to process. Let's just go ahead and select it. And we're going to go ahead and open it. Now, what you see in here is that I don't have auto save on. The reason I don't have auto save on it is because if I put auto save on, it will go ahead and grab the photos. It will process the photos. And once it processes the photos, it will save the photos out. There may be a time where I have to do some interaction to make sure that the outline is correct. And so what I'm going to do now is actually go into a photo. Let's just go ahead and do this. So I'm going to go ahead and close this right now. We're going to hit OK. Nothing has been saved. And so you can see they haven't even been processed yet. So they're in the processing state. You can see up here, this is showing you that it's being processed. Once it gets processed, it gives you the thing that tells you that it's been processed. The first one has been processed. So if I click on this one here, I can go in before I save this out. And if I needed to reprocess the photo, I can do that, right? So I would just go in here and look at what's going to, you know, there's been nothing added to it right now other than the preset has been selected. So we're going to go ahead and make sure that the outline is correct. And this is why you would do that. Let me just show you. Because whenever you get like this one's giving me 3 stars. It's telling me that it made a very good selection. The other one is giving me, it's not giving me any stars. So you want to go in and make sure that the selection has been, it's what you want it to be. Now, based off this selection here, I can tell you that if I process this photo, this would not have an issue. This is a good enough selection to use, right? And so with that outline selected, right, I'm going to choose the other one. And make sure that one's selected correctly. And it is. I'm just going to go ahead and move this up right here. And that has been done correctly as well. So with that done, and then I have the ability to say, show me the summary. Now we're back into the summary phase, right? There's no images that have been completed. Now I have the ability to add more images if I wanted to add some more images to this. Or I could go ahead and change the settings. And what I'm going to do with changing the settings is I want to click on auto save. And it'll give me the option of being able to save it where I want to save these photos to. It'll also give me the ability to change whether I want to make it a PNG, a TIFF, if I want it to be a large file or a small file. We're going to leave it on 100. And of course, we have this already selected. and we're going to go ahead and hit OK. Once they finish processing, it's going to give me a check mark with a disk over it to tell me that it's been saved. It'll also tell me here, right, that it's been saved out. And then once they've been saved, I'm going to show you how they look. They're going to have the same consistent look as the file previous. All right, so as soon as the fourth one is done, so all four photos are done. So now all I'm going to do is go into that location where those files have been saved. So let's take this out of full screen. And now we're going to click on each of these photos so you can see them. Processed beautifully. And let's go to the second photo. There we go. It has the same consistent look as the preset that we put on there. Excellent. So you can see these photos were processed and edited with the same look and feel of the previous one. That took us some time, took us a few minutes to create the preset, but this was done in a matter of seconds, not minutes, seconds. So if I had 20 photos, I could have processed 20 photos in less than 20 minutes, and they would all have the consistent look and feel of what I did as far as the how I want the face and everything to be presented and the makeup edits that I've made. So if you're a wedding photographer, glamour photographer, fashion photographer, this application is a must-have. I just can't stress it enough because speed is everything when you're processing. And in Photoshop, for me to do this look right here that you see on this model's face, it would have taken me no less than 30 minutes. I mean, no less. And that's if you do a quick edit and you have a kind of like a template of all of your layers and stuff saved and put in place by an action, it would take you about 15 to 20 minutes. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. The next tutorial for Portrait Pro 18 Studio Max, I'm going to show you how snapshots and the benefit of having snapshots and replacing backgrounds. And also we're going to change hair color and we can start playing with things like when you want to add a catch light in the model's eye, we can do those things as well. So again, thanks for watching.